Friends, I am S.R.Dulange, working as an associate professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to discuss the inputs and output of process engineering. We had one video. Under that, we have discussed industrial engineering related input. What is the learning outcome of this particular video? At the end of this session, students will be acquainted with inputs and output for process plan and understand the planning of process. Process engineering. Under process engineering, these are the inputs and outputs. Process planning is the input, industrial engineering is the input, quality engineering is the input, and external data is the input. Now, this is the inputs output model of process engineering. In the first video, we had discussion on industrial engineering, that is, method study and work measurement. Method study deals with process charts and work measurement deals with standard time. In this video, we will be concentrating on quality engineering. Now, under quality engineering, the first important thing is the process capability. What is the meaning of the process capability and how to make a process capable? So to understand this, we must have to understand what is variability. Variability is a natural thing. It is said that even twins are not alike. So in order to get the exact dimension, it is impossible to get the exact dimension. If we get that dimension, will be by chance. Now there are different kinds of variability. One is a assignable cause and second is a chance cause. Assignable cause is because of the man, material, machines and equipment. So difference among these all leads to assignable cause. And chance cause is relevant with the process. It is inevitable in the process. So chance cause could be because of a simple play between the nut and bolt, which leads to the different dimensions. Now, in order to understand the specifications and control limits, we must also know what is control limit. Control limit is nothing but limits for averages and established as a function of averages. So, control charts are generally built in order to have a control limits for different charts. Now, from a lot certain samples are taken and the dimensioning of each sample is done and the variation in the dimension is seen in order to plot a control limit for that particular process. Now, in case of R chart, which is a range, which means the minimum and maximum dimension for that particular product, and the average of all the ranges is nothing but the limits for averages. Now, specification limit means what? Allowable variation in size as per design document, that is drawing for individual values which are estimated by the design engineer. So we can also call this as a tolerance. Now, what is the process capability? It is a measure of the relationship between the voice of the process and the voice of the customer. So, one is relevant with the process and another is relevant with the customer, because the customer is giving the specifications for a product and a process must have to follow a mean in order to get the dimensions within the tolerance. It is essentially a ratio of the expected process variation and customer requirements, which is called as specification. Process capability is nothing but equal to voice of customer divided by voice of the process. Now let us take an example of the car and a garage. If the garage size is more than a car size, then we can drive the car very easily in the garage and we can park it. So the garage is nothing but a specification limit and the car is nothing but the control limit. So these are the three situations where the first figure shows the center of the car is at the center of the garage. In the second situation, it is moving towards one side. In the third situation, there is a friction or it is not on the wall of a garage. So it indicates that the third situation, the process is out of control. Now, process capability is also called as Six Sigma dash. Means what? 99.7% of the components should follow the normal distribution curve and is called as a natural tolerance also. It is also called as a spread of the process. Now, Six Sigma dash is nothing but a process capability where USL is nothing but upper specification limit and LSL is nothing but the lower specification limit. And the difference between these two, if it is more or less or equal, will decide whether the process is within the control or not. Now, there are some possible situations which are given here. Six sigma dash is greater than USL minus LSL. Six sigma dash is less than USL minus LSL. Six sigma dash is equal to USL minus LSL. Now let us take one example in order to understand this particular process capability. Now let us take a cylinder where the diameter of the cylinder is 20 and the tolerance I am assuming as 1. So the maximum dimension of this particular cylinder, which I am going to call is USL, is equal to 21. And minimum dimension of this particular cylinder, LSL, is equal to 19. So it will lead to USL is 19 and LSL is equal to USL is 21, LSL is equal to 19. So this is the mean of the process and this is the spread of the process. Now this spread is called as Six Sigma dash. Now in this case, USL minus LSL is greater than Six Sigma dash. So the process is within control. Now let us take the another situation where this is the Six Sigma dash. Now Six Sigma dash is greater than USL minus LSL, which means the process is not capable. So this is a rework which is to be made. And these are the components which are coming below the LSL has to be scrapped. So similarly, we can take the shift in the mean towards top side in order to see this is the rework. I will draw the second diagram. This is USL. This is LSL. So if this is the mean here, it is a scrap. So this is a simple example in order to understand the process capability. Now these are the references. Thank you.